Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be making brunch. I love brunch, my friends love brunch. It's something that we do pretty much every weekend. So I'm gonna show you guys a really simple, yummy way to just set it up at your house so you don't have to go out to a restaurant. And I'm also gonna show you a really good drink to make to go with it. So first we're gonna start off with some potatoes. I have red potatoes here that are chopped pretty small. And then we're gonna move on to some salmon croquettes. I love salmon croquettes. I have some canned salmon here with bell pepper, green onion, and garlic. And then we're also gonna make a crustless quiche. So kind of like a frittata. It's gonna be really good. So let's get started. Okay. All right, so let's start our potatoes. So in this pan, I have about a teaspoon of olive oil. I'm gonna add some dry rosemary. And now we're gonna add bacon. I just took some meat scissors and cut them into like little chunks. Let's go ahead and add this bacon in here. You want the bacon to pretty much cook all the way before we add in the potatoes. You want all that fat to come out. It's gonna be really good. The potatoes will absorb all the fat and give them a really, really good taste. So while that bacon is cooking, let's go ahead and start our salmon patty. All right, so let's make our salmon croquette. So I have one can of salmon meat, and I'm gonna go ahead and add our green bell peppers, our green onions, and then some fresh garlic. And now we're gonna crack an egg in there. Now it's time to get dirty. So we're just gonna go ahead and just squish everything together. And you can pre-season these if you want, but I like to season them after they're cooked, just topping them off with salt and pepper, because canned fish can get a little salty, so especially when you're frying it. So everything is pretty much mixed. So I'm going to go ahead and start forming our patty. So you want to take like a nice size ball that can fit in the palm of your hand. And here I have some cornmeal and some gluten-free flour, and just grab a little and kind of just pat it on top. This just helps everything stay together, gives the salmon croquettes a nice crust on the outside. And you can make these however big you want. I just like making them kind of small. So let's set our salmon croquettes to the side, and let's work on our crustless quiche. So I love quiche. My mom made quiche all the time when I was a kid. It was like my favorite thing. This way I'm doing it a little different. We're not going to use any crust, so it's going to be kind of like a frittata. So you just want to grab about 6 eggs. Go ahead and just crack those in the bowl. And we're gonna go ahead and add some half and half. And do about half a cup. Some people like using cream for their quiche, but I think it makes it too heavy and not that great. This half and half is really good. Here goes the 6 eggs. All right, so we're just gonna whisk this together. Everything is nice and blended. All right, let's add some salt and pepper to this. Kosher salt, a little black pepper, I'm gonna mix that in. Really good. All right. Now we have our nice casserole. Let's get some butter. I just kind of want to rub the pan down with butter. You don't want to use too much because it can get really greasy. So just lightly line the pan with some butter. All right, let's pour our egg in there. Let's add our veggies. So I like to do it this way. I like to do the mushrooms first. And then the bell pepper. And then the squash. And then a little bit more bell pepper. Just makes it look really pretty this way. And then we're gonna finish it off with some green onion. I think I wanna add a little bit more salt. All right, so let's set this to the side as well. And let's check on our bacon. All right, so you see how much fat came out of that bacon? This is gonna be so good. Now we're gonna go ahead and add our potatoes. We're not gonna season them just yet. I want them to absorb the saltiness and the fat from the bacon. So we're just gonna kinda turn the heat up, just stir it around. Gonna get all that nice fat that the bacon just kinda rendered out. Really good. The rosemary is still in there. Just stir it. Alright. We're just going to leave it on high for about 2 minutes and then we'll season it, cover it, and let it cook. Alright, so let's start on our eggs. So we have the oven set at 375. So we're going to go ahead and place this in there until they're nice and fluffy and just delicious. I'm gonna use some garlic salt. And some pepper. Let's give that a quick little stir. And then we're going to cover it. I'm going to turn the heat down to medium. Medium low. Alright, so while that's cooking, we can start making our salmon croquettes. Alright, so let's get our salmon croquettes ready. Just going to give it a nice little push. I'm just going to add it. I have about 2 tablespoons of olive oil in there. If you don't have a nonstick pan, you might have to use more fat for yours. Let's go ahead and just get them cooking. So these pretty much cook within like 4 or 5 minutes because the meat's already cooked. You're just kind of cooking the vegetables. Let's go ahead and flip them over. See how pretty that is? Nice and golden brown. That's why I love brunch. You can just have fun and make whatever you want. Uh-oh. This one's breaking apart. Alright, we're going to turn the heat down on this, and let's have a drink while all this stuff is cooking. Okay, so with brunch, I know people normally have mimosas, but I also like having some sparkling sangria with it. So good. So in here we have one bottle of Prosecco, about 2 cups of red wine, and then some watermelon, apples, and then some freshly squeezed orange juice. So we're just gonna go ahead and fill our glass to about halfway. And then we're gonna take some mango sorbet, which is about a tablespoon. Nice little dollop in there. It's really good, it's really fresh and light, and it still does the job that a mimosa would do. So enjoy. All right, so let's go ahead and stir our potatoes and bacon. Look how good these look. So nice and crispy and brown. It's gonna be so good, guys. And cool thing about red potatoes, they don't take that long to cook, so these are actually almost done. So we're just gonna cover these for about 3 more minutes. I'm gonna just check on our frittata for crustless quiche. And we still have some ways to go. So let's just wait until that is done. And our salmon croquettes are almost done as well. It's almost time to eat. Yeah. All right, guys, our crustless quiche or frittata, whatever you wanna call it, is out of the oven. So I'm just gonna go ahead and lay some baby spinach on top of it. And some really yummy sharp cheddar cheese. And I'm gonna place it back in the oven for about like a minute, nothing longer than that, just so the cheese can melt. Our potatoes are done. Just gonna go ahead, put those on a plate. All right, so let's go ahead and add our salmon croquettes. And pretty sure that cheese is melted by now. So now let's go ahead and add our frittata slash crustless quiche. And we're just gonna place that salmon croquette on top. Bon appetit.